Hello friends, welcome to Civil Twin. In this video, we are going to see about some important MCQs of geotechnical engineering, which is repeatedly asked in some competitive exams like TNPSC AE, TNEBAE, TRB, SSC JE and many PSU exams, especially in GATE also. As we all know, geotechnical engineering is known as the heart of the civil engineering because in every competitive exams of civil engineering, 1/4 of the marks are asked from geotechnical engineering. For example, we know in GATE, 10 to 15 marks are asked from GATE. In TRB, 20 marks. TNPSC AE, 20 to 25 marks. Most of the exams, 1/4 of the marks are asked from in this geotechnical engineering only. The first question is the accurate method of determining water content of the soil sample is, and the answer is oven drying method. If they ask accurate method, means the answer is oven drying method. If they ask what is the quickest method of determining the water content of soil sample is, and the answer is calcium carbide method. In some questions, sometimes they ask questions like in which degree Celsius the method is going to happen, means 105 degrees Celsius. The second question is the standard temperature at which the hydrometer is calibrated. That's Celsius. The answer is 27 degrees Celsius. If the temperature is greater than 27 degrees Celsius, means the correction is positive. If the temperature is less than 27 degrees Celsius, means the correction is negative. We already know the corrected hydrometer reading is equal to meniscus correction plus or minus temperature correction minus dispersing agent correction plus original hydrometer reading. The question may ask it like this: meniscus correction is positive or negative? Meniscus correction is always positive and the dispersing agent correction is always negative. The water content of the soil, which represents the boundary between the plastic and the liquid limit, is called liquid limit. If the boundary is between the plastic and the semi-solid, means the answer is plastic limit. If the boundary is between the semi-solid and the solid, means the answer is shrinkage limit. While testing a soil, threat test is conducted in the field in order to find out threat test, means the answer is plastic limit. For liquid limit, Cassegrain apparatus is used, and for the water content, oven drying method, torsion balance, pycnometer method, sand bath method, alcohol method, calcium carbide method and radiation methods are used. Among all, we already know oven drying is an accurate method. The ratio of the volume of water present in a given mass to the volume of voids in it is known as degree of saturation. We already know porosity is defined as volume of voids to total volume of the soil. Voids ratio is defined as volume of voids to volume of solids. Percentage voids. Na is equal to the ratio of the volume of air content to the volume of the soil into 100. The Van Schaer test is applicable to soft clay. Many of them confuse the soft clay and stiff clay. Don't lose marks in this simple question, sir. The answer is soft clay. The ratio of an unconfined compressive strength of an undisturbed soil sample of the soil to that of the remolded sample at the same water content is known as sensitivity. For liquefaction, in the question, cyclic loading wording is given in the question. For thixotrophy, loss of strength is given in the question. A soil having uniformity coefficient greater than 4 is called well-graded gravel. If it is greater than 6, means well-graded sand. If it is less than 3, means uniform soil. The method which is more suitable for the determination of the permeability of the sandy soil or coarse-grained soil means the answer is constant head method. For determination of the permeability of the clay soil or clay soil means the answer is variable head method. We already know hydrometer test is used for the particle size grain analysis. The next question is the constant of proportionality between the seepage velocity and hydraulic gradient is called as seepage coefficient. If they ask for coefficient of percolation, it is the ratio between the permeability and the porosity. Coefficient of transmissibility means coefficient of permeability into breadth. The efficiency of the group of piles driven in the dense sand is usually more than 1. Sometimes instead of dense sand, they may given as cohesionless soil. For cohesive soil, the efficiency of the group of piles is less than 1. Sometimes instead of cohesionless soil, they may given a clay. The next question is average permeability for the flow perpendicular to the bedding planes in a layered soil is for K perpendicular or K vertical. The equation is H1 plus H2 plus H3 divided by H1 by K1 plus H2 by K2 plus H3 by K3. For K parallel or K horizontal, the equation is H1 K1 plus H2 K2 plus H3 K3 divided by H1 plus H2 plus H3. Sometimes the question may ask K parallel or K perpendicular, which is greater? K parallel, that is K horizontal, is always greater. The Laplace equation for the isotropic soil is dou squared h by dou x squared plus dou squared h by dou y squared is equal to 0, because for isotropic soil kx and ky is equal. If the question is asked for the anisotropic soil, kx into dou squared h by dou x squared plus ky into dou squared h by dou y squared is equal to 0. Sometimes they ask the formula for k equivalent, that is root of kx into ky. This is very important question which is asked in many times in the competitive exams. Now we are going to see the types of boring. First one is auger boring. Auger boring is used for all the types of soils which is above the ground level, that means above the water table level. Wash boring is used for the soil except boundary stratum. Percussion boring is used for all the hot stratum, especially boundary stratum and gravels. Rotary boring is used to drill a large dia boreholes. Thank you for watching my video. For more video, subscribe my channel. In the playlist, there is number of MCQs videos for all the subjects and the questions are asked in many of the competitive exams. Those videos are very much useful for you. Kindly watch all those videos.